Hey guys, my name is Jason with Not Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to be running another cool sample I wanted to share with you guys. So come on in and take a look. This is some copper chops that we got from one of our international customers. And so he sent up several different samples. This is everyone's favorite, comm wire here. And it's been through his grinder, his granulator, but there's still copper wire in there that has insulation on it. And so we're gonna run it through our hammer mill and onto the shaker table and see if we can recover some of that copper wire. The next one here is some real fine number two wire. It looks like it might be either lamp cord or insulated number two extension cords, stuff like that, real fine hair wire. So we're gonna run that through the system as well. This is a sample of some probably high recovery number two wire that has already been through his air table. And there's still some real fine copper hair wires in there. So we're gonna run that through the hammer mill to wet it onto the shaker table to recover that fine copper that his air table has missed. Here's a sample of the same material, only with the copper in it. This hasn't been through his air table yet. So we can maybe eliminate a step for him and run it all through our system, and he won't need his air table anymore. This is some number two wire as well, and I'm not quite sure what it's from, but the insulation is really thick and it's really heavy. And so you can see there's some paper and some fluff in there. So we're gonna run that through the system. And the last one here is some of this real fine hair wire, single strand stuff. This hasn't been through his table yet, but you can see there's a lot of pieces that haven't been fully liberated. The copper is still inside the insulation. So we're gonna try and break all that up and recover the copper out of this one. And lastly, we have a sample of clipped ends from printed circuit boards. And there's not a lot of copper in here, but there's a bunch of little gold conductors at the end of some of these pieces. And on one side it's solder, and the other side it's a little gold contactor of some kind. So we're gonna run these through the system as well and try and recover some of that gold and other precious metals in those boards. So here's the system we're going to be using today, and this is our demo system. This is a 16 by 12 hammer mill. It has a gooseneck inlet on it, so I'm going to feed the material in here in the inlet. Water is fed up into the back of the hammer mill to help flush everything down and through the system. The hammer mill has a quarter inch punch plate screen and those blades that we've shown in some of our previous videos. So they're not hammers, it's more blades on this system. It's going to come down out of the trough here into our aluminum distribution trough onto our shaker table. The table has gated valves here so you can adjust the feed rate onto the shaker table. The light plastic fluff and all the paper is gonna come down into our number four, into the waste. The copper is gonna get caught in these grooves, run across under the concentration water bar and into the number one and number two port. And then the number three, we're gonna see what happens there. I suspect there might be a little bit of plastic mixed in and maybe some of the longer hair wires may get captured in number three that we can then rerun through the system and collect the copper again. So we made a little bit of a change for running the trims and the board edges and stuff. We used this screen instead of the quarter inch punch plate because there weren't any components on the boards that we were using. So we wanted to make sure we got them ground up real fine on the first pass, and that way we didn't have to recirculate anything through the hammer mill again. And this is about a 1 millimeter slot here, and we've taken our welder and we've just welded beads all the way around the screen, and so you end up with about a 1 inch long by 1 millimeter wide slot. And that seemed to work really, really well for liberating all the copper out of the boards and the little bit of gold that was on the boards because there were no components on it. We're trying a little bit of an experiment here, and we've put these light plastic sheets over the shaker table top because some of the fine copper was actually floating on the water surface. And so we've added these plastic sheets to break the surface tension and force the copper wire underwater, which then allows it to come across into the number one and number two on the shaker table. And you can see here when I lift up the plastic sheet, the copper actually floats on the surface of the water down into the number three. And so the plastic sheet we used actually did a really good job of breaking that surface tension and allowing all that metal to come over into the number one and number two. Here's the inside of our hammer mill with the hood taken off. And I wanted to show you guys the screen we used on the wire samples. This is a quarter inch punch plate hole, and the screen wraps all the way around both sides of the mill. And this is the rotor. And for our PCB and wire samples, we use these blades. And they're 3/8 AR 400 steel. And we plas cut them out to have these points on them. And so as the hammer mill rotates around this way, the blades catch and grab the boards and the wire and drag them down into the mill and crush them up. And so this is a little bit different than our hammer mills for ore, but wanted to give you guys a shot of the inside and show you the screen we used on the wire. Here's the results from our copper wire across the shaker table. And after talking with the customer, we learned that there was actually two different types of samples here. And so I wanted to go through and talk about each one. This is actually copper wire. There are 3 or 4 buckets of this material that was actually run through their single shaft shredder and had not been granulated yet. And as you can see, we got pretty clean copper wire, but the issue was is they had that comm wire sample in there, and each one of these little insulations of comm wire have copper wire still inside of them. So even though the copper wire came across clean, if there's any copper wire that's still insulated, it will come across the shaker table into the number one. Conversely, they sent a sample of material that had gone through their granulator. And this is the material here once it had been fully liberated through their granulator. And you can see it's 100% clean copper. The shaker table actually did a really, really good job on this material because the copper wire is small enough and it's fully liberated. So we ended up with 100% clean copper directly from the granulator. So thanks for watching our video on processing copper wire chops and unpopulated PCB trim through our shaker table and hammer mill. I think it went really well. I was really impressed with how clean the copper came out with the granulated wire, and also how much copper there was on the shaker table. I don't think I've ever seen that much metal on our shaker table before. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know. You can call or email, which is in the description below. And thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.